Anything special on the agenda today?
Yes, there's the opening of your retrospective at the Museum of Modern Art. Hmm. The gallery director left 4 messages asking to confirm your attendance.
Hmm. I haven't decided yet. We'll see about that later.
Okay.
What else?
Just your usual fan mail. I've already answered.
Hmm. Any news from Leo?
No, Carl. I can call him if you like.
No. No, don't bother. I'm starving.
Well, your breakfast is ready. Bacon and eggs, just the way you like them.
Thank you, Marcus.
You're welcome.
Television. Why don't you find something to do while I finish my breakfast?
Sure.
Hmm?
Okay, Carl.
On the other hand, last night, the American ambassador again informed an emergency meeting of the UN. That the United States would not accept this annexation under any circumstances. Several American destroyers are recorded to be headed...
What are you reading?
Oh, Keats's Odes. It's one of the books he recommended.
So, what do you think?
Well, there's a lot of sadness in his poems.
Hmm. Keats was in love. There's nothing like love to make a man feel more miserable. One day I won't be here to take care of you anymore. You'll have to protect yourself and make your choices. Decide who you are and want to become. This world doesn't like those who are different, Marcus. Don't let anyone tell you who you should be. Let's go to the studio. Let's see where we left off. Remove the sheet. So, what's your verdict, Marcus?
Yes, there is something about it. Something I can't quite define. I guess I like it.
The truth is, I have nothing left to say anymore. Each day that goes by brings me closer to the end. I'm just an old man clinging to his brushes.
Carl.
But enough about me. Let's see if you have any talent. Give it a try. Try painting something.
Paint? What would I... Painting what?
Anything you want. Give it a try. That is a perfect copy of reality. The painting is not about replicating the world. It's about interpreting, improving on it, showing something you see.
Carl, I don't think I can do that. It's not in my program.
Go on, go, try it. Grab that canvas. Do something for me. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Trust me. Try to imagine something that doesn't exist, something you've never seen. Now concentrate on how it makes you feel and let your hand drift across the canvas. God.
Hey, Dad.
Leo. I didn't hear you come in.
Oh, I was in the neighborhood. I thought I'd stop by. It's been a while, right?
You all right? You don't look so good.
Oh, yeah, I'm fine. Hey, listen, I need some cash, Dad.
Again? What happened to the money I just gave you?
It just goes, you know?
Yeah, you're on it again, aren't you?
No, I swear, it's not that.
No, don't lie to me, Leo.
What difference does it make? I just need some cash, that's all.
Sorry. The answer's no.
What? Why?
You know why.
Yeah, I think I do know why. You'd rather take care of your plastic toy here than your own son, right? Tell me, Dad, what's it got that I don't? Smarter? More obedient? Not like me, right? But you know what? This thing is not your son. It's a fucking machine!
Leo, that's enough. Enough.
You don't care about anything except yourself and your goddamn paintings. You've never loved anyone. You never loved me, Dad. You never loved me.
Androids weren't allowed in here. Thank you.
Lieutenant Anderson. My name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife. I looked for you at the station, but nobody knew where you were. They said you were probably having a drink nearby. I was lucky to find you at the fifth bar.
What do you want?
You were assigned a case early this evening. A homicide involving a CyberLife android. In accordance with procedure, the company has allocated a specialized model to assist investigators.
Well, I don't need any assistance. Especially not from a plastic asshole like you. Just be a good little robot and get the fuck out of here.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant, but I must insist. My instructions stipulate that I have to accompany you.
You know where you can stick your instructions?
No. Where?
Never mind.
I understand that some people are not comfortable in the presence of androids, but
I am perfectly comfortable. Now back off before I crush you like an empty beer can.
I think we can go now.
You little prick. I don't know what's stopping me from knocking you out.
Your sense of duty, Lieutenant. And the cost of repairs if you damage me. For your information, I'm worth a small fortune.
Wonders of technology. They can even program assholes these days. Gotta go. Duty calls.
Say, Lieutenant.
Fucking A, whatever I say.
Josh Douglas for Channel 16. Can you confirm that this is a homicide?
I'm not confirming anything.
Androids are not permitted beyond this point.
It's with me. What part of staying in the car didn't you understand?
Your order contradicted my instructions, Lieutenant.
You don't talk, you don't touch anything, and you stay out of my way. Got it?
Got it.
Evening, Hank. We were starting to think you weren't gonna show.
Yeah, that was the plan till this asshole found me.
So, you got yourself an android, huh?
Very funny. Just tell me what happened.
We had a call around 8 from the landlord. The lieutenant hadn't paid his rent for 2 months, so he thought he drove by, see what was going on.
I found the body.
Victim's name's Carlos Ortiz. He has a record for theft and aggravated assault. According to the neighbors, he was kind of a loner. Stayed inside. Most of the time, they hardly ever saw him.
Calling everybody out in the middle of the night. Could have waited till morning.
I'd say he's been there for a good 3 weeks. We'll know more when the coroner gets here. There's a kitchen knife over here. Probably the murder weapon.
Any sign of a break-in?
Nope. The landlord said the front door was... locked from the inside. All the windows were boarded up. The killer must have gone out the back way.
What do we know about his android?
Not much. The neighbors confirmed he had one, but it wasn't here when...
arrived. I gotta get some air. Make yourself at home. I'll be outside if you need me.
Perfect. It's way too neat. No human rights like this. Chris, was this written in the victim's blood?
I would say so. We're taking samples for analysis.
Red ice. Seems our friend Carlos liked a party. Chris. So I want full analysis on the narcotics.
Consider it done, Lieutenant.
Thank you.
locked from the inside. Killer must have gone out this way.
There are no footprints apart from Officer Collins' size 10 shoes.
Well, this happened weeks ago. Tracks could have faded.
No. This type of soil would retain a trace. Nobody's been out here for a long time. Stabbed 28 times.
Yeah. Seems like the killer really had it in for him.
Lieutenant, I think I've figured out what happened.
Oh, yeah? Shoot, I'm all ears.
It all started in the kitchen.
There are obvious signs of a struggle. The question is, what exactly happened here?
I think the victim attacked the android. With the bat.
That lines up with the evidence. Go on.
The android threw the chair.
No, that can't be right. It doesn't fit the evidence.
Android stabbed the victim.
So the android was trying to defend itself, right? Okay, then what happened?
The victim fled to... the living room.
Tried to get away from the android. All right, that makes sense.
The android murdered the victim with the knife.
Okay. Your theory's not totally ridiculous, but it doesn't tell us where the android went.
It was damaged by the bat and lost some therium.
Lost some what?
Therium. You call it blue blood. It's the fluid that powers Android's biocomponents. It evaporates after a few hours and becomes invisible to the naked eye.
Oh. But I bet you can still see it, can't you?
Correct.
Yeah. Hey, what are you doing with that chair?
I'm going to check something.
I was just defending myself. He was gonna kill me. I'm begging you. Don't tell him.
Connor, what the fuck is going on up there?
It's here, Lieutenant!
Holy shit. Chris! Ben! Get your asses in here now!
Dinner is ready.
Yeah, I'm coming.
There wasn't much in the kitchen. I did what I could.
Life's funny. I lost my job because of androids. And I need somebody to take care of this goddamn house. Android. What a joke. Of course, androids are so fucking wonderful. They never fail. They're never tired. Never sad. They're so fucking perfect, they ruin my fucking life. What's your fucking problem? Not the life you dreamed of, eh? Maybe you think this is easy. Maybe you think it's my fault we live in this fucking shithole. My fault your fucking mother took off! You should stop taking drugs, Todd. Sometimes you really scare me, Todd. Bitch took off without a word. Fucking whore walked out on me for a fucking accountant! It's all your fault.
Daddy, no!
It's all your fucking fault! Get back here. Come back here? Come back here right now! You stay there. Don't you dare fucking move, or I'll
bust you worse than last time.
I took off without a word.
Leave her alone.
What the fuck are you doing? Put down the gun and get the fuck out of here. That's an order!
No! I want you to leave her alone.
You want? What do you mean you want? What are you gonna do? You're gonna shoot me, is that it? Are you gonna shoot a human? You seem to have a problem. I think we need to fix that.
Ugh!
That was by far the most boring party I've been to in the last 25 years. Every time I go to one of these, I ask myself, what the hell am I doing here? I hate cocktail parties and all the schmoozers that go there.
Well, it's a chance for all those people who admire your work to meet you.
Yeah. No one gives a damn about art. All they care about is how much money they're gonna make out of it. Come on, let's have a drink. Oh, the excitement of this whole thing has made me thirsty.
Scotch, neat as usual?
Absolutely.
Okay, but you know what your doctor would say.
Yeah, well, he can kiss my ass. I'm old enough to choose my own medication. Did you leave the light on in the studio?
No, I'm sure I didn't.
Call the police.
Detroit Police, what's your emergency?
This is Carl Manfred's android at 8941 Lafayette Avenue. We've just returned home and found the lights on. There may have been a break-in.
A patrol car is on the way.
Let's go check it out. Marcus, no. I'm with you. What are you doing?
You refuse to help me, so I'm helping myself. It's crazy what some people pay for this shit.
Don't touch them.
Look, they're all gonna be mine sooner or later anyway. Just think of it as a down payment on my inheritance.
Marcus, get him away from there. Get him out of here.
Look, I've already called the police. You should go now before you get yourself into more trouble.
All you ever do is tell me to go away. What's wrong, Dad? Not good enough for you? Not perfect like this fucking thing?
That's enough! Get out! Right now!
What makes it so special anyway, huh? What's it got that I don't...
Leave him alone!
Come on! Let's see what you got!
Marcus, don't defend yourself, you hear me? Don't do anything.
Go ahead, hit me. What you waiting for? Think you're a man? Act like one!
Stop it!
What's the matter, too much of a pussy?
Stop it, Leo! Stop it!
Too scared to fight back, you fucking bitch! God, you're not a real person. You're just a fucking piece of plastic.
No, Leo, leave him alone.
No. I'm gonna destroy you. Then it'll just be me and my dad. I'm gonna tear you.
God. Leo. My little boy.
Carl, I...
They'll destroy you, Marcus. You gotta go. Get out of here. Get out! Now! Go! Marcus!
Don't fucking move! Thank you.